Steve Dotto, how are you today? I'm doing just fine. Thanks for asking. Today I want to talk about getting more out of our web browser. Now, I have to admit that I've been a bit of a philandering web browser user. Back in the day, of course, I used Internet Explorer, and then once Firefox came along, I was madly in love with Firefox. We had a torrid relationship that lasted for quite some time, but Firefox kind of got slow and didn't seem to quite do it for me anymore, and I found a new browser. I found Chrome, and Chrome and I formed a bit of a bond, and now I've moved over to Chrome, and I spend most of my time with Chrome, although I do spend some time in Safari and a little bit of time in Firefox occasionally. I feel a little bit guilty about jumping from browser to browser, but that's the nature of me, I suppose. I'm just not cut out to be a one browser kind of guy. Having said that, I really like what Chrome brings to the table currently, and I'm using it an awful lot. And I thought I'd share with you like 8 awesome features that are within Chrome that will make your web browsing experience that much better, because we spend so much of our time now in our browser. So without any further ado, I'm going to lightningly quickly go through 8 features within Chrome that you might want to incorporate. And the first is one that I know you're going to want to use. It's called pinning tabs. And what you do when you pin a tab is you take all of these large tabs that we have across the top of the window here and you make them small. This is for the tabs that you always have open. If there are certain pages that you're always at, regardless of what's going on in your life. For me, I use email in the browser, so I always have my email open. Well, instead of taking up, see all this physical space here that it takes up? Right-click your mouse on it, say pin tab, and it reduces it down to about a quarter or less of the space. I've still got the tab there. It's still using up resources and all that. It's not like it's going to make the computer run faster, but it's going to take less real estate here at the top. So by pinning a few tabs, the tabs that you always have open, that is a great way for you to reclaim some real estate at the top of the screen. Now, don't go crazy doing this. Don't decide that you can have all of your bookmarks open because this tabs can take up a small amount of space, because every window you have open takes up some resources in your computer. You lose a little bit of memory and the computer is going to perform a little less fast as a result. But for the ones that you want to always have open, this is a great way to set them up and to always have them open. And while we're talking about open tabs, a lot of times, depending on what services you sign up for, you can lose your presets. You can have, you know, when you first install Chrome, it's going to open to the YouTube or to the Google page. But then if you install different services, sometimes you'll notice that all of a sudden your search preferences change or something changes within your settings, and when you open a new window, it opens to a different page, or when you start a browser session, it opens to a different set of pages. Well, you can set that up and you can regain control over that by going into your settings under Chrome Preferences, go into your settings area, and there, I just clicked away from it, there it is. You go into your settings area, and then on startup, you can ask it to open a new page or open a specific page or a set of pages. So if you want to have like 4 or 5 pages that you always open to when you start a session, you can set this here in set pages. Now be warned that typically when you install a file downloading service or some other types of apps or some other type of services that you might sign up for, it'll sometimes change these preferences. It's kind of one of the deals that these guys do in order to make money. So they might change your settings, so you might have to go in here from time to time and reset it. Along with that reset is sometimes the need to reset where you go automatically for search. When you type in this bar at the top, which interestingly is called the Omnibar because it's not a search bar or a URL bar anymore. No. This bar along the top does far more than just bringing us to websites, which I'll talk about in a moment. We call it the Omnibar in Chrome. But when I'm typing in a search here, by choosing which search engine from this pop-up menu here within my settings will determine which is the search engine I'm going to use as my primary search engine. And sometimes people will change that to Yahoo or to Bing if you install a service. So if it automatically makes some changes to your preferences, you go back in here to rechange that. Now, while I'm talking about the Omnibar, let's stay on that and let me show you one of the coolest things. This is an intelligent bar. You know, you notice now that it's always making suggestions as you're typing. And as you start to type in a search, it's bringing up the most relevant searches that have been asked for by other people in that same area. But it does more than that. It also does math for you. So instead of having to open your calculator if you have to do some simple calculations, and if you just want to figure out 48 times 6 is, watch what happens. When I put in 48 times 6, it gives me the answer here. And this works for lots of different types of equations. So you don't have to go to the calculator and open your calculator app when you have simple calculations to do. You can do it right in the Omnibar. Isn't that cool? I knew you'd like that one. Let's talk about something called incognito mode next. Now, incognito mode, when we've signed in, we know that using cookies and different things like that and preferences, when we return to websites, quite often they recognize that we've been there before, and a history of our visit to those websites is built up within our web browser. And that is something that we don't necessarily always want to have happening. Some people, because they're going to websites that they don't want other people to know about, don't necessarily want to have a history recorded of them visiting the website. But a little more legitimately, sometimes we want to be able to sign in to, say, into a different Google account without having to quit and sign out of our existing account. I've got multiple Google accounts for different purposes I have. So rather than starting a new browser session in a different browser, what I can do is I go and I right-click on the Chrome icon here on my taskbar, in my menu bar at the bottom, and I create a new incognito window. And it's got this little spy thing happening here. So what happens here is it's not going to be recording any of the history, and it doesn't have any cookies or any, it doesn't create any internet trail of my journey here online. So I'm in incognito mode. I'm in stealth mode. So if I want to sign into a different Gmail account, I can do so in incognito mode. And that way I could have multiple instances of my different Google accounts running at the same time. So that's a pretty cool service as well. Next up, I want to show you how to detach a tab. Sometimes as we're working, we might want to have multiple windows open, and we might not want to have to go jump back and forth within the different tabs here. What we can do is we can actually, by grabbing a tab, we can either rearrange where it is in the list, in the sequence of tabs along the top. You can just drag it. Or if you drag it out into the window, you can create and turn it into an entirely separate window just by dragging it. And that works really well when you're cutting and pasting in documents, or you have one document that you want to have open the whole time while you're researching other documents or while you're doing some other sorts of writing. So I quite like that ability to occasionally grab a tab, drag it out. And hey, guess what? You can also drag it right back in. And if you grab on the tab there, you can drag it back in and you can reincorporate it into your main window. Pretty slick, eh? The next feature is one of my absolute favorite features that's built into Chrome. And that's the ability for me to use my Google account to sync my instances of Chrome across multiple devices. In other words, all of my bookmarks, all of my passwords, all of my different settings and preferences that I set up here on my main desktop computer, I can mirror those settings on my notebook or on my tablet any other place that I use Chrome. And I do that once again by going into the preferences. And oh, by the way, I'm going into the preferences here from the Chrome menu. You see these little bars over here on the side of the browser? I can also go into my preferences and my settings here by clicking here in that menu. And when I do either one of those two menu settings, I'm brought into this sign-in area that allows me to connect it to my Google account. So I'm connecting this instance of Chrome to my Google account, so to my Gmail account, basically. If I do that, then I can set it up so that the preferences sync across. And if I click here on the Google dashboard, it will tell me all of the different types of settings and all of the different data that's being synced across into the different platforms, into my notebook and into my tablet, because I've got it set up for all. So I've got 9 apps, 22 extensions, 69 settings, history, autofill, so that it automatically fills in things like addresses, passwords are saved there. All of that and all of my bookmarks are all saved in multiple instances using the Chrome sync feature, which is just awesome. Now, the last thing that I want to show you is something that a lot of people don't use. A lot of people will search for, they'll do a Google search for something. They'll open a page once they've searched for it and found it, and then they scroll through looking for why that page was recommended to them, especially if they're searching for a term. And a lot of times we forget that you can just hit the Command key F or Apple key F to find within a document, and then you type in a word and it will highlight that word. It will find that word within a document. So just like in a word processor, you can do a search within any web page or any website that you're in, or the page that you're landed on, right within Chrome. So those are 8, I think, awesome simple tools, ones that I use almost every day and have become second nature for me, to make your web browsing experience that much more efficient. Now, I shouldn't disparage any of the other browsers. Most of them will do a lot of this. Things like the Chrome Sync is kind of unique, and there are workarounds that you can do in other areas with that. And other browsers have some other features that are cool, and maybe even cooler than some of the ones we looked at. But for me right now, Chrome is the leader of the pack, in large part due to a lot of these different interface things that they've added. I hope you found our video today to be useful. If you have, please subscribe to our videos. That way you get first access to the video as it comes out each and every week. And I love to see that number of subscribers climbing. It tells me that we're doing a good job, and everybody likes to be told they're doing a good job, don't they? So thanks for spending time with us this week. We'll see you again next time right here on Dotto Tech.